friends, welcome back. My name is Dawn and this is Living a Word-Filled Life. And today I want you to know that you are invited to the banquet table. Jesus wants you to come to the banquet, to sit with him, to spend time with him, apart from all the noise that's in the world. And I had a dream this week and I'm going to share that with you. And it's not about me. This video is not about me. It's about Jesus. And I would just want you to know that Jesus wants us all to come to the banquet table. He wants us to draw closer to him, and then he will draw closer to us. And I was reminded of that. It's kind of funny. I call it a God wink, how this all worked out, because I had this dream and I wrote this Bible study knowing I would do it this week. Well, on my Facebook post, this post popped up from 8 years ago, and it said, come near to God and he will come near to you. And that's from James 4:8. So it's almost like God saying, you know, I called you to do this 8 years ago, but he is so good and he is so faithful. And even when we don't listen, he comes back around. He's like, okay, we're going to give this another try. But recently, before I saw this post, I felt like I needed to spend more time alone with Jesus. And my friends know not to call me first thing in the morning because I have my Jesus date. And usually I take some time, I try to every day, and spend time alone with God. And you know, I would take time, but it would only be like 30 minutes or, you know, less than an hour for sure. And so I just felt this week that I need to spend more time. Like I have this desire to spend more time with God, more time with Jesus. And so what I did is I set my clock for early in the morning. I am not a morning person. For those of you who know me, know that I'm not a morning person, but I'm like, you know what? I can't make any more hours in the day, but I can take away some sleeping time and get up early. So I set my clock. Well, alarm goes off early in the morning, and I do what I always do, is I hit snooze. So when I hit snooze, between that time and the time I woke up, I had a dream. And I want to share this dream with you. And I'm not a, you know, big prophetic dreamer person, but I just think this dream has some significance. And I do want to share it with you guys. But in the dream, I was watching something that had already happened, but yet I was there. You know how dreams are. So I was watching it, but in the dream I was physically there, but it had already taken place. And I'm going to show these pictures that I pulled from Pinterest to give you an idea of what I saw. This came as close as I could get to what was in the dream. But in the dream, there was this beautiful banquet. It was almost like a wedding reception. And they had beautiful fall colors. It was in a garden, a beautiful garden. And the tables were real long and set with china and candles. And it was beautiful. And in the dream, I knew that this event was special and it was very hard to get in. Like you had to call ahead and make a reservation, but there were more people trying to make the reservations than people that can actually get in. So it was pricey, and it wasn't pricey in cost. It was pricey in you had to hurry and get in and get your name in before it closed, before all the tickets were gone to reserve your space. So in this dream, there's people, there's thousands of people enjoying this banquet, and they're laughing, they're talking, they're singing, they're telling stories, and they're just having a great time. And then I see these servers come out, and they're holding these trays of food, and it's almost like, and again, I'm going to pull from Pinterest on this, a charcuterie board, but for individuals. Like each person had their own board. And so the servers were putting them all in front of each, you know, person, and they were enjoying the food and laughing and just having, it was a fun time. But I looked over and I saw this server, and she was walking around with one plate of the food, one board, and she was just looking around, looking everywhere, and she was looking for someone. And then I watched all the eyes turn to her and turn to this one spot that was still reserved. It said reserved. But that person didn't show up for the banquet. And you could hear people whispering, like, oh my gosh, can you believe that person got in, but they didn't show up? How would you not show up to something so special? And it wasn't that they were condemning that person. They felt bad that that person is missing out on all the stuff that's going on, all the joy of the banquet. And then the server looked at me, and I knew it was me. I had made the reservation. I had set my clock early, but I didn't show up. So let me tell you what happened when I woke up from the dream. It was before the snooze went off again, which is every 15 minutes. So from when the clock was set and before 15 minutes were up, let me tell you something, sister, brother, I was out of that bed. I'm like, I am so sorry, Lord. I had a date with you and I had a reservation and I didn't show up on time, but I'm here. So I did go to the banquet, so to speak, and I did show up. But here's what happens when you show up. God shows up. And I want to share these next pictures with you, because while I'm with Jesus that morning, I've got my worship music on my computer. You can kind of see it in the picture. But look at what came through the window. And it's not like our house faces east. It wasn't time for the sunrise. It was hours after that. I had been up since sunrise, but this glory of God just showed up. He just showed up and showed off. And I was able to capture that in pictures. And I want to share that with you. And again, it's not about me. Please, please, please do not think this video is about me. It's about Jesus, and He wants us to be with Him. If you show up, He is going to show up. And this is extra. It's outside of the normal prayer time or worship time. It's just extra time with Him, a special feast, a special banquet. And He wants to have that time with each and every one of us. This whole scenario reminded me of a passage in the Bible, and it's from Luke chapter 14, verses 16 through 24. And I'm going to read from the Passion Translation. And it says, "There was a man who invited many to join him in a great feast. When the day for the feast arrived, the host instructed his servant to notify all the invited guests and tell them, 'Come, for everything is now ready for you.' But one by one, they all made excuses. One said, 'I can't come. I just bought some property and I'm obligated to go and look it over.' Another said, 'Please accept my regrets, for I purchased 5 teams of oxen and now I need to make sure they can pull the plow.' Another one said, 'I can't come because I just got married.' The servant reported back to the host and told him of all their excuses. So the master became angry and said to his servant, 'Go at once throughout the city and invite anyone you find, the poor, the blind, the disabled, the hurting, and the lonely, and invite them to my banquet.' When the servant returned to his master, he said, 'Sir, I have done what you have asked, but there's still room for more.' So the master told him, 'All right, go out again. And this time, bring them all back with you. Persuade the beggars on the streets, the outcasts, even the homeless. urgently insist that they come in and enjoy the feast so that my house will be full. I say to you all, the one who receives an invitation to feast with me and makes excuses will never enjoy my banquet. So God is calling us to his banquet. He's not looking for our excuses anymore. Apparently, I've had excuses for 8 years, but he's not looking for our excuses. He's looking for us to schedule time, make our reservation, show up for him, and sit with him at the banquet table. So, you be blessed. Thanks for being here. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Thank you.